Blackstone Audio presents The Deeds of My Fathers, How My Grandfather and Father Built New York and Created the Tabloid World of Today, by Paul David Pope. I dedicate this book to the untold millions of Italian immigrants who left their birthplace to seek their future and fortune in a new country. This book has been written with all of them in my mind and heart. My grandfather, Generoso Pope Sr., and to his namesake, Generoso Jean Pope Jr., my father. My precious children, Valentina Generoso Pope, Reeve Jean Pope, and Justin Tanner Pope. Foreword: A Tale of Three Sons. I initially intended to write only the life story of my father, Jean Pope Jr., a remarkably complicated man who founded the National Enquirer. His story alone is certainly worthy of a book. But as I was researching his life, I came across the transcript of a dictated note in which my father indicated his true feelings for me. He described me as the second coming of Generoso Pope Sr., his father, who came to America in 1906 with $10 in his pocket and not a word of English in his vocabulary, and went on to become one of New York City's wealthiest men and an influential power broker in the city and the nation. Streets and tunnels, bridges, skyscrapers, and airports were constructed with materials supplied by his company, Colonial Sand and Stone, while national opinion was shaped by the media companies he came to own. The Deeds of My Fathers thus became the saga of both men and how they changed America. The women in their lives also played important, often colorful roles in their success. Some were strong figures who could be as ruthless as their husbands. Others were crushed while the men in their lives forged their careers. In the end, few were left untouched by the lives of Generoso Pope Sr. and his youngest son, Generoso Paul Pope Jr., known widely as Jean. Their stories encompass immigration, ambition, wealth, power, ruthlessness, crime, punishment, betrayal, and redemption. They involve organized crime and its role in my grandfather and father's climb to riches and power, and in the careers of mayors, judges, governors, and presidents, all providing singular insight into the corruption that fueled urban and national politics for so many decades. I have chosen to present my father and grandfather not only as ambitious visionaries, but also as the imperfect human beings that they were. Dark sides of them invariably emerged from time to time. They were complex, conflicted individuals with flaws and foibles. Some people were hurt by their deeds, while others prospered because of their vision and ambition. Finally, there is a personal reason I have been driven to tell the tale of these epic American lives. I wanted to put between covers the whole story about my two forebears, much of it never told before, so that I might also learn and know myself better. Throughout, I have been determined to shine light on all sides and let the chips, the light and the dark, fall where they may. Many of the most important events in the Pope family's history were private conversations among family members. Unlike what a reader today might almost expect, there were no devices recording the conversations during the decades covered here, and no historian stood near my grandfather or father as events occurred. Instead, the means of transmission for posterity was most often a family member talking to a relative or with someone who worked for a Pope family business. Fortunately, my grandfather and father were gregarious in discussing their lives and careers, as were others. I want to assure the reader that everything included in these pages is here because, to the best of my knowledge and memory, it corresponds with what all the best evidence suggests was actually said and what actually occurred. All dialogue was included only after research confirmed that certain meetings took place and only when multiple sources indicated what was said in those meetings. Throughout the entire process, stretching over more than a decade, my unswerving goal has been to maintain fidelity to the true character, verifiable motivations, and authentic personality of each person portrayed here. Paul David Pope, Weston, Florida, June 2010. Prologue: A Meeting with Frank Costello. In December 1951, my father, Jean Pope, went to see Uncle Frank in the hope of securing a loan for a business venture. Uncle Frank was Frank Costello, inheritor of Lucky Luciano's power, and head of New York's Genovese crime family.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.